We're here at Baldwin Farms and we've come to pick out a pumpkin for a jack-o'-lantern and also maybe get some cooking pumpkins, maybe some gourds as well. We're here with my daughter Chelsea and my son-in-law Chris and my grandson Carter, who is long gone somewhere in a little red wagon. So we'll catch up to them and we'll show you what goes on here at Baldwin Farms.
Yeah, those are just display. Let's see what we can find. Some fresh herbs, and salsa for sale, apples and cider.
This is a hay maze, and my grandson Carter, you'll see right here, is moving along through the maze. Let's hope he makes it out.
Get down, Bubby.
Hurry. And you made it.
Cooking pumpkins right here. I'll probably be back for those. We have some gourds around here and lots of pumpkins in decoration with gourds. And on down here, looks like we have some rabbits. So just some livestock here, and over here some chickens. In the middle here, there are some pieces of Indian corn, and they've got a contest. Name the rabbits. Here we have some goats, looks like. So this is just a really nice place for kids to come and look at some things they don't get to see every day in their front yard. There. That you hear so much about. And he's all ready for Halloween. He's in the mood.
Hi, spider.
You're not scared, are you?
No.
Spiders are good, aren't they?
Uh-huh. Because they're happy.
Yeah, they make you happy. Uh-huh. Do you like this place?
Uh-huh.
It's fun, isn't it?
Because these are real weird things.
Real weird things. I agree.
What are you doing? I jumped off.
We're having a really good time out here today at Baldwin Farms near Richmond, Kentucky. And since I'm here with my family, we're just kind of in a very relaxed mood, walking around and looking at what they've got to show at the farm. And it's mostly fall type things. So you're going to see a lot of pumpkins and some gourds and some Indian corn, some things like that. And then they've got it kind of decorated up so that they're fun things for the kids. And we have our little kid running across the field there. That's Carter. And our little dog over here at the spider playing with another dog, which is a real treat for him, for Remy. We're beginning to seriously look at the pumpkins, trying to find one that will be carved out to make a nice jack-o'-lantern. Hopefully Rick will do the carving and I won't have to worry about that. And if we pick up some cooking pumpkins, then I will plan something made of fresh pumpkin. Haven't decided exactly what, but as soon as I know, or pretty soon after I know, all of you will know. Carter, which one is yours? Is it in the wagon?
Where's mine at? Here. This is mine.
Okay, now which one is Grandma's?
Yours, right there.
Yeah. You think those will make nice jack-o'-lanterns?
Uh-huh.
We'll see. I'm just taking a look at a few of the things that they have available here. They have some nice chrysanthemums. If you want to buy chrysanthemums, they have them in different places, but this happens to be one trailer that has them. And over in this direction, you can kind of got some acorn squash and some butternut squash. So you might want to take a look at those. And the pricing is very obvious, so let's move along here. This is a variety of pumpkins and gourds. And there are some birdhouse gourds and dipper gourds. You can see the shapes of those. And here we have dried gourds. And you can hear the seeds inside rattling there. Small pumpkins here, I think these are for children. These are labeled kid pumpkins. And then here's a whole trailer load of, looks like tiny pumpkins. They call them tiny pumpkins, 3 for $1. And some gourds. And I was picking out some gourds just for decorating, but I probably should do that by really going through them and looking at them well. And more down there, you can see another trailer's worth of gourds and different types of squash. And then over here, it continues. And you can see it's just a lot more of the same. I've been picking through the gourds and pumpkins here. I have one tiny pumpkin, and then I just picked what I thought were very interesting looking gourds for decorating the house. And right now they look kind of messy. They have dirt on them, but I will clean them up and you'll probably see them again. One of the things I wanted to get here was a cooking pumpkin. And so I picked this one out. Let's just look at it and make sure there's no damage to it. It looks fine. So I'm gonna make something out of this and we'll see what it is later on.
These, in case you want to pass it on to somebody. And do you want recipes?
Yes.
Recipes. And this this little pumpkin right here is the real good cooking kind. So if you want to make pies or something else,
okay, that's great. Thank you.
You're welcome back.